Name some domestic appliances that really nobody wants.
La, la.
In a vicarage, a tie rack.
That is good. I'm appealing, sir, that this is an act of great pedantry here, but there's not technically an appliance.
Oh. And it's an electronic tie rack.
An auto steam tie rack.
There are electric tie racks. Yeah, there are tie racks that go
like really? That.
Yeah, there are.
Such a thing
you,
exists.
Ones, I promise you.
Wow.
And that actually takes us to what the right answer is. When you said steam, yeah.
Those Corby trouser presses that you have in hotel rooms. Yeah. I've never seen anyone use or heard of anyone using.
Brilliant. Do you mean others don't?
You've used
the only one.
I use them.
But not necessarily for trousers.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
Whoa.
Anyway, there's a whole load of appliances that were made in the 1920s and 30s, when a lot of British people were starting to get a little bit more prosperous just before the crash, and they thought about going on the electric, as it used to be said. Ooh. We're going on the electric. And what would be the killer app that would put them on the electric, the thing they wanted to have most?
Electric light.
That would be one.
Plug-in radio.
The wireless set.
Whoa. Yeah.
And who are the other main suppliers other than electricity? That had
gas.
Already been there, gas. They thought, well, what we'll do is provide gas-powered radios stop people from going on the electric. And there's an example of one. And they put them out and they said, oh, not only will you get the BBC, but you will warm the room slightly.
Slightly. Increase the glow of your contentment.
Increase the chances of your house exploding. And not only did they produce wirelesses, they produced trouser presses. Oddly enough, washing machines, washing up machines, everything that you can think of that is a household appliance, a white good, as we would now say.
There were gas-powered fridges, weren't there?
Yes, there were indeed. Very much so. Hmm. But they just didn't catch on because electricity was just more reliable. And it's not that the gas actually powered the radio so much as that the gas created the current that powered the radio. So it was still electric, it's just you use your existing gas main.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Well, please, come on, pick something.